don't leave a legacy. Hello and welcome to the SOS Show Live with Mary Evans. SOS stands for Share Our Stories. I'm your host, and I believe that there's power in sharing stories. On this platform, we are dedicated to bringing you content that will elevate, motivate, inspire, and educate you with the goal of you living your best life physically, mentally, spiritually, and financially, which leads to leaving a legacy and building generational wealth. I would like to introduce to you my special co-host, Marcia Easley. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Hi, Mary. How are you? Ooh, I like that applause.
Marcia, at the end of the day, mm-hmm. It's all about a legacy and building generational wealth for me.
That's it.
So that's it. Why. That's it right there. Generational mm-hmm. wealth.
Yes.
So today we're going to talk about it. You know, I'm going to sit back, sip on my coffee.
Hey.
We're going to talk about the importance of leaving a legacy and building generational wealth.
Okay.
You know, Marcia, so many things go on in the world, and we know money don't solve all problems, right?
No.
We understand
right.
that.
That's
but we
right.
also understand, in order to leave generational wealth, in order to help others in the world less fortunate than us, is that we must make money. You know, Marcia, as I drive through different cities and hear about different businesses that have been shut down because of the coronavirus, you know, it makes you really take a look at how important things are and how we definitely have to take it more serious, the way we mm-hmm. save, spend, and invest our money to be able to leave a legacy, build wealth. And not only that, when emergencies occur, Marcia, because I'm going to share with you, sometime when we're making money, we never think that things are going to go wrong. So when the most unexpected things happen to us, we losing our home, we losing cars, we going to bankruptcy. So many things happen. And I'm going to be a little transparent with you, Marcia. I'm going to share a story that I'm experiencing right now in my life.
Okay.
You know, I bought the business, downtown Pontiac Co-op working space, right? And I gave mm-hmm. events, parties, everything you can imagine. We did downtown Pontiac at 7 North 2nd on your emergency space. I was down there 16 months. Matter of fact, the SOS show was birthed out of that. So I received a call from the owner of the building. Now, I'm all about ownership. I was trying to buy two buildings across the street and it under appraised for $100,000. And I couldn't work out a deal with the owner. So I said, okay, let me just go down across the street. Maybe the Lord just want me to test out my vision, which was I wanted to start a co-op space where small business owners could come in and have a space to work, rent mailboxes, offices, have conferences. We did fashion shows. We did everything you can think of. So the coronavirus really shut me down. And we're going to talk about using the talents to make money when things happen. So I haven't been booking anything since the virus. I talked with the owner a couple months ago. He was like, okay, let's try to roll this out. Let's revisit this at the beginning of the year. But he since has decided that he wanted full rent. And I'm using this transparent story when it comes to building wealth and leaving a legacy. Because I'm very fortunate. My parents always pushed that to us, and they definitely have built generational wealth and leaving a legacy for my siblings and I. So I was a little upset, Marcia, because he asked me to be out in 30 days. After I finished having my pity party, I pick up the phone and I call my mother. And my mother, and you know, my mother and father, you know, they the ghosts, they beasts, and they have instilled everything that you see me do when I talk about it. Marcia, my mother said, we have a whole building that's yours, that's paid for. And you crying about he asked you to leave. Guess what, Marsha? If I just wasn't in a family that understood legacy and generational wealth, because we're in the real estate game as well, everybody just don't have that opportunity or bless to be able to say, boy, what am I worried about? I can take my whole business to a family-owned business
building
and run business as usual, like nothing has ever happened. But sometimes we miss out and we don't think about our blessings. And only because my parents are building wealth and leaving a legacy, I'm able to pack up and move like the Beverly Hillbillies, do the same thing I'm doing rent-free. I just want to be downtown so bad, Marsha.
I know, because, you know, most downtowns, you know, in any area are the places to be and usually the hardest places to get into. But I don't really think that you wasn't thinking about your blessings and missed out on. You know how blessed you are and always have been. But I know you were trying to do your thing. You know, you didn't want to do it off of what they've already instilled in you. You wanted to do it on your own. So I understand. I understand, my friend. I understand your pain and your pity party that you were having. So.
Yes. So we'll be out in 30 days. And it's just like, it's almost like, I almost felt like after the conversation, she was like, just come home. When you first started the business downtown, I told you could do the same thing here, but I wanted to do, like you say, my own thing. And it was almost like, come home. So I'm saying this to say that's why everything that I do, I push leaving a legacy, building generational wealth, and the things that I do is so if my children are in trouble, Marsha, they know that they can come home. If they're doing the right thing and things happen out of their control, it's all about that. So
when
exactly. When they're doing the right thing, we always want to position ourselves where we have a child, like things like the virus was out of their control and they run in a business. When you are mindful of the way you spend your money, you can help out when there's a crisis. That's what you want to do. And that's why you hear me all the time. I push even my 10-year-old grandson, who knows all about investing, Marsha, stock, business. He's dropping his online business subscription the end of the year.
That's awesome.
You know, he knows about gold, land. He has, and he's 10 years old. And I'm saying that we, at one point, have to say to ourselves, if we never live to see the change, we have to do things today and hoping that our future generation, our grandchildren, have the mindset of an entrepreneur, the mindset of being an investor, the mindset of, I don't want to be rich, I want to be wealthy. Wealthy is a different measure between being rich and being wealthy. Do you know, we just had that conversation yesterday. My grandson and I went on a walk, and I underestimate how much he has retained, because I've been pushing this since he was five. I asked him a question, is it better to be rich or wealthy? Actually, he surprised me. He said, Granny, wealthy. And I asked him why. He said, because of my wealthy, the money keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going to each generation. Most rich people go broke. And until we start educating ourselves in regards to what is the difference and how we must learn how to invest and save, then it's like a generational curse. Generation after generation, they're struggling, they're working check to check, working a 9-to-5. And even, Marsha, we know that business is not for everyone. I understand that. But I think that everyone should have something on the side where they can generate passive money, making money while you sleep. So let's talk about this, Marsha. I'm going to ask you a question.
All right.
If you walk into your job today, because we all have talent that we can use to make money. We all have that talent. I have multiple streams from doing things to make money where I don't have to physically be there working a 9-to-5, putting in the hard labor. If you work, sometimes we don't even sit and think about it, and we all are talented in some type of way. So if you was to lose your job today, take a moment and think about your talents. And Marcia, tell me, how could you make money if you were cut off today from your 9-to-5?
That's really a good question, Mary. So first and foremost, you know, my passion is math. So I've always extended an offer to parents. You know, I always did it on Facebook everywhere. You know, if your kid needs help in math, I'm available. Call me. And even right now with Zoom and everything else, it's even easier to get to them. You know, we don't have to do anything. I don't have to do face-to-face. I don't have to worry about transportation issues and stuff and things like that. So, you know, I could charge to be a math tutor. This, you know, and that's my passion. It's something I love to do. Because we know when you're trying to deal in the stuff that, you know, looking at what your passions are and what your talents are. I know math. I like math. I can teach math. I've been teaching my granddaughter how to play the piano. I'm not the best pianist in the world, but I know how to read music. I know how to teach beginning piano.
Awesome.
My granddaughter can read music now. She can play the piano. And at first she thought it was a punishment, but the more she does it, she likes it. So, you know, that's something you can also do, because you can even teach that online. A person can have a little keyboard, even a makeshift keyboard. We can make that happen. You know, things you can do, and it's something that you can charge to do. I've always been involved with Girl Scouts and everything else. Crafts. I know how to do all kind of crafts. I can teach how to do crafts. And, you know, there's so many other things you can, you know, I can make some money. I can, like, I published a book. I can teach people. If you want to publish a book on your own, if you want to learn how to do it, I can tell you what I did. I can teach you the steps. I can do whatever I need to do. But, you know, usually it's something that I like to give back, Mary. But if I had to make a living from it, I could do it. You know, if it was something I needed to do to make, money, I could do it. So that's just a few, because, you know, everybody think I'm Jamaican anyway, because I do so much. But that's just a few of the things that, you know, just right off the top of my head that I could do to try to make some money.
I like that.
Marsha Harris said that here. I was going to say that we got a little comment here from Marsha Harris. Want me to read it?
Yes.
She said, when unexpected things happen, unexpected blessings occur. Mm. My daughter owned 2 businesses, and she set up an school corner for Chase for schooling. They work side by side, and he's observing and soaking up the knowledge. So yeah, so her daughter is doing it, and her grandson is getting the knowledge too. That generational stuff going on right there, Mary. That's what we're talking about. Yes.
We are, Marcia.
Mm-hmm.
All of a sudden I see some echoing, and I'm finna see what's going on because I want to hear this show.
Okay.
Do you hear me echoing?
I don't. You sound clear to me. No echoing.
Okay, good. Cool. So, Marcia, thank you for that comment, Miss Marcia Harris. And we really appreciate you tuning in and watching the SOS show. It's very important to me. It really is, because everything we bring is all about to help and elevate others. So I had to think about and step out of the box and see what other things that I can do, Marcia, because I was hit very hard with the COVID. Very hard.
Oh, I know.
So sometimes we just have to learn how to shake and move and do things creative and think out of the box. Sometimes we have to downsize. You have to do whatever you have to do to make it work. And I think a lot of times the ego get in the way. And, you know, if we used to a certain size home, we don't want to go smaller. We used to driving a certain type of car. I believe that sometimes we go in debt trying to impress other people. I had to drop down in different areas and happy to be able to do it again. Mm-hmm. Let's go back to when you preparing for saving our money for emergencies, because I had the opportunity of moving from my home in West Bloomfield to another home I had in Southfield, right? But guess what? Some people can't drop down, Lord, because they don't have it to do it. So that's why when we have it and we're making it, we have to do things that could help us in an investments with the money. So I thought about, what else could I do? I have a transportation business. I was able to keep that going, although it was hit very hard. Mm-hmm. Let me tell you, Marcia, I had a guy pulled up in his car to deliver me a package from Home Depot.
Mm-hmm.
I saw him put the package on but it was nothing on his car but the package. So I out come to the door. I said, excuse me. I said, where are you delivering the package? He said, Home Depot. He said, they're looking for people to transport because they have a problems getting packaging out, right? Mm-hmm. And they do third party. Girl, I got on the phone and called my sister and I say, call Home Depot, call Lowe's, call everybody that we can. So you see how I'm so used to transporting people. I had to think out of the box and say, you know what? We can go after contract transporting mail, transporting for stores that's looking for someone need transportation needs. And I always did so well in the area of non-emergency transportation, mm-hmm. motor vehicle cases. I just never thought out the box. Then I started thinking, Marsha, I did a sizzle. I wrote a TV reality show, right? Right. That I have just sitting on the shelf. In the right time it happened, hopefully we'll get it on BET or something because that's who I was pitching to. Yeah. Then, Marsha, I have a gold sealed it on a dog patent. So I know about the patent process. I know how to put the team together to make a sizzle for a reality show. I did group homes for traumatic brain injury for 20 years. I know that how to help someone if they want to go into the business of starting a group home with my eyes closed. What do you need? How to pass all of the inspections? And I'm like, you know what? We never think about all the talents that we do have where we can generate income. And I had to really sit down and think about this because I asked the question to people. I now have my license to sell life insurance. I just became partnership with a loan company. I'll be able to help new businesses get startup money long as they have a credit score of 620. When you talk about investing, I always try to do what I preach in my portfolio. We talk about different ways to invest. I talk about gold, silver, real estate, stocks, patents, owning your own business. And so in my portfolio, I have all of that. So I really know how to get someone on the right track as far as building a portfolio. Then I started a nonprofit teaching children business. And that's why I'm working with my grandson. We dropping subscriptions where you could just go online and download information very cheaply because I want everyone to be able to afford it and the whole family can sit down. Right. And a lot of times when we're trying to teach the kids, they won't listen to us. But seeing another 10-year-old doing it, I'm hoping that they grasp and want to hear more about investing in business. So I contacted a guy to do videos and I'm getting ready to put a video together and say, it's time to monetize your skills and your talents. So anybody out there listening, I'm asking you to take a second, get a pen and paper, take a second and write down your skills. You will be amazed. But I'm telling you, you know, you have some friends, you know, Donna Jean Brown from Pontiac, your close friend of mine. Girl, I asked her, write down your skills. She was like, well, I can dance real good. I say, girl, stop. You know where she was going with it, right?
I know. Don't say
it. But for some people, that would be their skill. For some people, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So this show is all about trying to motivate and getting others to think about what is it that you can do? And I'm going to share something else with you after I take a sip of my coffee.
Okay.
I was reading this. If you have a home business, mm-hmm. you have children in the home, find something that they can do. Find something that they can do for you in that business. I don't care if it's stuffing envelopes. I don't care if it's putting a stamp on the letter. I don't care if their job is when the boxes come into the home from UPS, your business, things you've ordered, they have to open the boxes and put them on the table.
Find
something that your child can do to help you in the business. And you know what else you do, Mom? You do when you give them that task. Mm-hmm. I don't care if it's $5 a week. You hand it to them and start teaching them how to save money. You pay them $5 and you tell them you can spend two, but you have to save three.
That's me. That's what I do.
As little as that. Yeah. Teaching them about the importance of making money and saving money. You can start just as that. So all you all the people out there that have a home business, sit down at the table with your kids, give them a task that they must do. And then they feel like they are part of the business. Believe you wouldn't believe what they will be learning from responsibilities and you holding them accountable and you paying them, but they cannot spend all of the money. We have to start with the kids. Okay. Yeah. I think that is so awesome. And so when you do that, they just be so excited to help you.
Yep. Yeah. You know, oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Part of the business. Yes. Chase is launching the end of this month where you can get your child a debit card and online. They were selling it was a green card, but you can get your child a card and you can put their allowance on the card. How much they have to save, and they're going to have an application that's going to help the child have a better understanding of saving money and spending money, and it launched. So, guys, it's an awesome program they're doing. It launched the end of this month, and that's Chase Bank. I love it. I can't wait until that happens. Yeah, isn't that awesome? Because I think awesome. It starts with the kids, and it's all about we have to change so we can live a better life, just period.
Mm-hmm. Yep. I know.
So, guys, we just came on this morning hoping to motivate and inspire someone to change your mindset, the way you save, spend, and invest your money.
Yeah.
It will not be long. I'll be launching a page where you will be able, and it's called Black Exit, BLACXIT. Exit out your current situation into a better one. On this page, Black Exit, you will be able, if you need life insurance, which is very important in the Black community, we have to start getting, I don't care if it's a policy where you pay $25 per month. A lot of legacies were left through life insurance policies.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of these people that's rich, that don't look like you and I came from life insurance policies, right?
Yes.
Marshall, if you need money for your new startup business, you'll be able to fill out an application for monies for your business. If you need a website, you need to be incorporated or trademark or wholesale resale license, you will be able to come to Black Exit and get everything on one page. I'm all about Black economics and how we can build the Black community and leave a legacy and grow generational wealth. Black Exit coming soon. BLACXIT. If you would like to leave anything with the audience today, Marsha, what would that be?
First of all, let me read what the SOS Show Live got up here. It said, make your child a part of the bill paying process at home. Show them the bills. And that is so true because they take for granted that those lights and that water and that heat is just automatically, just magically coming on. But you need to show them. And that's what I used to do. I used to show my kids my paycheck. I'm like, this is what you need to aspire towards. Then I would show them the bills. I said, now you think I'm making this? But look what I got to give out. Look what I have to put out every month. So you definitely need to make your kids, your grandkids, everybody in your family aware of everything that's going on. Because, you know, Mary, we're in different times right now. And we have to be creative. And we have to be inventive with everything we do in order to make money and save money. So I just want to say, just keep in mind what Mary said, what I'm saying right now, you know, just save. Don't just keep all that extra spending that you're doing. I know that that unemployment money was great. You know, it was awesome. But, you know, if you're still getting it, you know, like Mary said, put a little bit aside, but always save some because you just never know how long this is going to go on and when is the next emergency going to happen. That's all.
Absolutely. Marsha, that was a great comment. Do you know, as we get up every morning thinking about how we can save money and invest money, is somebody else getting up every morning trying to see how they can get the money out of your pocket? That's why we have the commercials we have, the ads that we have. It's their job to come up with creative ways to get us to spend money. So we have to stop being bamboozled by that. And I'm telling you, I want to, Marsha, I will go in a store, and particularly since the pandemic, I've always been a saver. And if I had not been, I don't know where I would be today because I had to tap into them savings very hard.
Yeah.
But Marsha, I would go into a store, get to the counter to pay for it, and have a basket full of stuff I don't need. Now I'm more mindful. I used to put it in a basket. Have you ever got to the counter and you just be like, I don't need this, I don't need this, and you put stuff back as you move to the cash register? Marsha, I have did this multiple times. I had a pair of navy blue shoes. I'm saying, now why do I have these navy blue? I have 5 pair. I don't wear those. What am I thinking? But their goal is, that's why, Marsha, when you go to the store, you notice it's just as much items in the checkout. You can't even get to the cashier to pay for your items. They have rows. As I'm standing there, I'm picking up stuff put into the basket. So I know that I have involved, and I know I'm learning and growing, because now, before I put it in a basket, if I see these glasses, Marsha, I'll be like, oh my God, them a nice color. I literally stand there and be like, do you need those glasses, or do you just like them because you don't have that color, because you got 20 pair on? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Purses.
Yeah.
Girl, I have so many purses. It just don't make no sense. So all we trying to do is get you, when you go into stores, mm-hmm. when you pick up an item, mm-hmm. stop and say to yourself, do I really need this purse? Do these kids really need another jacket? Do I really need another pair of boots? That's all it takes, because it's people out there that's working so hard to get that money out of your pocket. And they're doing a good job. They're doing a good job.
That's true.
All right, guys, thank you for tuning in on Sunday morning coffee and conversation with Mary Evans and Marsha Easley. We see you next Sunday at the same time, same place. Be safe. Hold on to your dollar like it's your last, because it might be. Have a great day. Yes.